I got black, I got white, what you want? Hop outside a ghost and hop up in a phantom. I know I'm about to blow, whoa, whoa, I ain't done. They try to take my flow, I take the after ransom. I know that I'm gone, they see me blowing up. Now they say they want some. I got two twin Glocks, turn you to a dancer. I see two twin ops, leave them on a banner. I got two thick thoughts, wanna link the game. I got red, I got blue, what you want? The Chanel of Balenciaga, Louis and Vuitton. She know I got the Fendi Prada when I have Milan. I needed me a Diorada, I need me the one. I started from the bottom, you can see the way I stung. I want all the diamonds, I want that shit to wear a ton. The ops, they tryna lie me, cause they hate the place I'm from. But them niggas don't know me.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. If you guys are new, you guys already know what to do.
But you ain't want me laughing, so just get up on my face. They all up in my inbox, so I know they wanna taste. I know they want my downfall, a nigga, are you late?
Thank you guys so much for the support you guys have been giving me in the past. But anyway, I'm Luis Borja, and today we're gonna talk about how you guys can stop procrastinating. In high school, I really didn't procrastinate as much as I did in college. Plane going crazy. And I think the big reason why I procrastinate so much in college is because I have a lot of time. In high school, I'd be going to school the entire day, and I'd go home, I'd go to work, and it's the same cycle, right? I didn't really have much time to do anything I really wanted to do. Now that I'm in college, like I have a lot of time that I can kill, a lot of time that I don't really know what to do with. In high school, I used to use a planner, and I was able to like look back on the tasks that I set for myself during that day, and I could check it off when it was done. And it just kept me on a schedule. It made me more productive in the day. So you know, the fact that it helped me in the past, I brought it over to college. I have my planner. As you guys can see, I literally keep it in my desk. Like, it's not even in my backpack anymore. I used to actually write stuff down here, but I figured out the more I wrote in there, the less time I actually like opened it and looked in there, because like there were so many tasks in there, it like kind of freaked me out, you know. So I kind of just gave up on the planner. It didn't work for me. But I recently started using Google Calendar. Use a digital calendar. Digital calendars come in so handy, and like they're literally perfect. You can get notifications that remind you to do something, and you can set like a time range, so it could be like a week from now, be a day from now, it could be 15 minutes, it could be 5 minutes from now. It keeps you productive in your day, and it makes sure that you're doing your tasks that you wanted to do. So what I changed, I guess, is in the past I kind of just wrote it down in my planner and just threw it to the side and never opened it anymore. But now that I get these notifications, literally the first thing I do in the morning is I open up my laptop and I schedule what I want to do throughout the day. And yeah, sometimes I don't know exactly what I'm gonna do every single second of the day, but that's fine. I'm just giving myself a little rough schedule for me to follow throughout the day, so I can stay on my tasks and stay productive. And when I first started doing this, I found out that I was scheduling myself really short. Like, for example, if I thought this video was gonna take me say an hour to do it, I would literally just put an hour down. If this video ended up being like an hour and a half or 2 hours, then I was already behind my schedule and I was already onto the next task when I was simply on the first task and I never even got finished with that one. So it kind of just rushed me and kind of just stressed me out a little bit more for no reason. And now that I found myself guilty on cutting myself short, I tend to give myself an extra like hour. I run myself longer. So if this video is actually gonna take me an hour to film, I'm gonna put down 2 hours. So then I actually have a little bit of flexibility in my schedule and I have some time to do other things. Basically what I'm saying is use a digital calendar for one. For two, give yourself more time than you actually think that you need. And that's the first thing on my list. My next little topic, some of you guys might think like, bro, this is common sense. Everybody knows this. But like, I'm just sharing my experience. Like in the past, I didn't know this and I do this now. So I'm gonna share it with you guys anyway. In the beginning of college, I procrastinated a lot and I literally put everything off to the last minute. So I'm sharing my experience to you guys. Work in advance. And when I say work in advance, this is what I mean. For example, if you go to class and you have an essay scheduled for the end of the week, don't wait till the end of the week. Don't wait till Friday at 11:50 when your essay is due at 11:59 to type your essay. And that just causes stress and unwanted anxiety. So why would you wait till the last minute when you got the whole entire week to do it? So what I started to do, if I have an essay due up Friday, I start on Monday. I start the day that they tell me to do it. If I have a lot of time, let's say like on Monday or Tuesday, then yeah, I'm gonna write a little rough draft on the whole thing. And then throughout the week, like on Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday, I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna make simple little edits, simple little touches, just so I can keep myself ahead of that deadline. So that's another tip on how you guys can procrastinate less. Work in advance and give yourself the time that you guys need. In the past, I considered myself a very productive person, and it died when I got to college. But now that I'm back on this schedule, I do consider myself a very productive person. And considering myself a productive person doesn't mean I'm productive 24/7. Like, No, I'm not productive. I'm lazy as hell. If you guys know me, you guys know I'm lazy. But productivity does not mean you're working every single second of the day. It just means that the tasks that you set out for your day, you guys can complete in the day. But another tip that I'm gonna give you guys is once you guys feel productive, like once you guys get that little urge to do something, go crazy. And going off the topic of being productive and being motivated to be productive, this might seem a little bit obvious. I'll say start off with your hard ass task right away. And if you start off with your hard task right away, this gives you time to take breaks in between and even cross off other tasks on your list. Like maybe you guys wanna go to the gym. And if you guys wanna go to the gym, take a little break in between your hard tasks, because this is already hurting your head. And doing something like going to the gym is not a really mental strength. So that's why I say you start off with your guys' hardest task at first. So then your mind is already working hard as hell. And you guys can take more breaks. And then at the end of the week, you're just left with your simple little tasks that you guys may or may not even have to do. So yeah, those are my tips on how to be productive and how to not waste your time. Because you guys know, like I said in my past video, time is the most important asset that you guys will like ever have. Time's not gonna wait for you, and if you're not gonna work with time, then time is not gonna work in your favor, like ever. So let's conquer time and let's be productive together. If you guys wanna keep learning the importance of time and, you know, just being well-rounded people, hit the subscribe button below, because I'm gonna keep on making these videos for you guys so you guys can be successful people in the long run. So if that sounds good to you guys, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and comment down below which videos you guys wanna see and which topics you guys wanna see me cover in the future. This is Luis Borja. You guys are watching Project Sploosh. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Peace out.